learn how to conduct process capability studies for attribute data in this video. I will guide you through the fundamentals of process capability studies, breaking down each step in a way that's easy to follow. You will gain a solid understanding of the fundamentals before diving into the process capability of attribute data. By the end of this video, you will be able to apply the concept of process capability to generate attribute process capability index. We shall start by looking at the process capability studies in variable or continuous process parameters to understand the fundamentals of process capability studies. This is the illustration of the concept for process capability. In this diagram here, we have the voice of the process in red here, which is lower control limit and upper control limit. And we have the voice of the customers, which is represented by lower specs limit and upper specs limit, USL. As you can see that if we have the voice of the process, the variation is smaller than the total specs tolerance, then we consider this as a good process. In another scenario, we have the voice of the process. The variation or the spread is very big. It's bigger than the voice of the customers. Therefore, anything that is beyond the specs, the LSL and USL, it will consider as a defect. This type of process is not desirable in any manufacturing process because the potential of producing defects is very high, and definitely there will be defect. The CPK index value are actually corresponding to a defect PPM. If we look at the sigma level of 2.5, which is a CPK of 0.33, this means that we will have about 160K reject here, meaning that this is what it looks like. This is the specs limit. That means we will have a lot of parts which is out of the specs limit, either on the upper specs or on the lower specs. That will depends if the CPK is CPU or CPL. If the sigma level is 3.5, which is corresponding to a CPK of 0.66, means that we will have about 22.75K of reject, which is still high. And then at 4 sigma level with a CPK of 0.83, we will have about 6,000 plus PPM. And at 4.5, which is at 1.0 CPK level, we will have 1,350 PPM of reject. This is actually an opportunity of reject. So at 5.0, we will have about 1.16, which is corresponds to a reject rate of 232. And at 5.5 sigma level, which is the most desirable CPK value, and we always heard about CPK value of 1.33, the PPM should be around 31.5 PPM, means that there are very little chance for reject, and means that the process is very good, is inside the specs limit, and the chances of it to go outside is very little. Therefore, there will be less reject here. And at the famous Six Sigma level, the CPK is around 1.64, corresponds to 3.4 PPM checks. The process capability study purpose is to use the CPK to estimate the process reject rate based on the statistical principles of Z-test for a continuous normal distributed data. We can then predict the process reject rate for the future process or a product parameter that we cannot measure 100%. Discover our meticulously crafted course, SPC, and Process Capability Mastery, designed to empower your journey in manufacturing process control. Throughout this program, we will dive into the fundamental principles of SPC, exploring topics from process variations to supplier quality management amidst the Industry 4.0 landscape. Learn how to showcase your skills using SPC to prevent failures. Moreover, we will unveil the intricacies of process capability, furnishing you with the tools to streamline processes and deliver unparalleled product quality to your customers. Scan the QR code or click the link below to enroll in this course for just $12.99 with my coupon rates. Unlock all of my courses on Udemy for only $12.99. If you are using a mobile device, simply tap on More to review the special rate course link. Click on the link to view over 15 courses in multiple quality areas offer. For desktop user, you can scroll down and click on the link to download the course list. You can then click in the list to get the special offer rate. In order to know the process capability value for an attribute data, we will need to calculate the reject rate, such as from an inspection process. Once we have the reject rate, we can already find out the CPK value using a statistical software or manually through a statistic Z table. We can then match the PPM with the potential, the CPK value here. If you find this video informative, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel for more valuable insights and updates in manufacturing supplier quality hacks to achieve consistently good quality products. By subscribing, you will be the first to know when I post new content. There are quite a number of opinions regarding whether CPK or PPK for attribute data can be calculated. Some guru will tell you to use the yield data. Once we understand the fundamentals of process capability study, which is used to estimate the potential reject from a process, my take would be there's no need to calculate the PPK data anymore. We would already know the reject rate of the attribute data collection directly. You can use the reject rate or PPM to reverse engineer to determine the process sigma and also find the process capability from the table I give you in the earlier slides. I hope that you have a better understanding on the purpose of process capability study and also whether process capability study is needed for attribute data. I hope you found today's video helpful in gaining a better understanding of manufacturing, supplier, and quality engineering. I'd love to hear your thoughts on what topics you'd like me to cover, so feel free to share your comments below. If you find this video valuable, please share it with others who might benefit from it too. Thank you for watching, and I can't wait to bring you a more insightful content in my future videos.